The concern I had when they were posted, the knowing what work went into the downtown with the greening committee after the last meeting, or a few meetings ago, and they put together a plan, and it, for the Quinnipiac Street area, and I think what disturbed myself and a lot of other people downtown was with the recommendation and the work that went into that and the total disregard of that plan, taking the trees out, all the trees that really didn't need to come out, but all the trees that came out and putting new trees back in the same locations. When it was identified by the Green Committee that other locations, moving them a little bit one way or the other and relocating some quite a distance would be more beneficial. The Greening Committee, it was more than just a group of citizens that really had no knowledge or limited knowledge. This Greening Committee was put together with people that had enormous knowledge with urban plantings and trees in particular. And I know the mayor's concern was budgetary. We heard it in council chambers, and I've heard it, you know, we can't afford the good trees, or the recommended trees, we take that. We can't afford them, they're too much money. And I come to find out that there are other nurseries throughout the state that do have that species of trees that were never contacted, that actually the cost could have been brought down. That's history. That's Quinnipiac Street. I didn't want to see happen on Center Street the same thing that happened on Quinnipiac Street. So I had met with a member of the Greening Committee, and we talked. And I said, out of the 38 trees, in your opinion, out of the 38 trees that need to come down, how many are actually need to come down? Or how many are good? And he said, there's 22 that are good that really don't need to come down. And that was a concern. I asked him that question because right outside of my store, one storefront over, there's two small trees, approximately, I think they got maybe 3-4 inches in diameter, that really have never been pruned, but they're small trees. And I said, what a shame to take those out. And that's what got me going with a member of the Greening Committee. And that's when I asked him that question. And he said, 22 trees are good. So then, doing some simple math, came up with the idea, well, why don't we leave the 22 trees that don't need to come down? Take the money that we saved on those 22 trees, and for the 16 remainder trees, buy the right trees that were recommended, the ones that the mayor said we can't afford. Just moving the funds around. And I know some do have to come down, some are diseased, some are just too big. But I just hate to see a wholesale slaughter of trees coming down because they all have to match. They don't match now. The trees that are down, they don't match. There's different species. They're not all the same species of tree. And I know, Henry, this is not your thing. This is what I'm just reiterating what the mayor has said. That they all need to look the same. They all need to be flowering trees. They all need to be. And it's just not right. I just hate seeing that healthy living tree take taken down just because they all need to match. So, I'm going to stop there because there's others that want to speak. And I'm hoping Mr. Liu will speak, member of the Greening Committee, or Mr. Austin. But they're the ones with the credentials. They're the ones that have the degrees. And so I'm going to let them speak a little bit more on this. But those are my concerns. And that's one of the reasons I call this public hearing. And I had people ask me, I had customers, and I had people from other sections of town say, well, what's wrong with the trees? Why do they all need to come down? We don't understand. So if anything, maybe you can help us understand why they all need to come down. Thank you.
Good afternoon, Mr. McCauley.
Good afternoon.
I think what we've all kind of come to a conclusion of is that we see something and we care deeply about this town. We care about the way it looks. We care about how it thrives. And the trees are part of that whole aesthetic. And we really don't want to be in a continued adversarial role, because I think when the bottom line is that we all live here together, and I think, and I know that I think we all have the best interests of this town at heart. And what we're looking for is someone to meet us halfway. Again, like John said, I don't have expertise, so the environment is a huge concern on my part. But we kind of helped in this process, and we defer to the people that do have the expertise. And what they've given us is a whole train of thought and reasons why not only would this be viable economically and save the town money in the long run, but it would also give diversity and beauty to this town and be an attraction and an asset to this town. And my hope is for this hearing is that you could take this back to the mayor, and that this time we could really collaborate. I've walked up and down Center Street a number of times since I saw you that day tagging the trees. And I've looked at the ordinance many times. And in terms of infestation, I really don't see that, but I'm not an expert. But I know that this time, unlike Quinnipiac, there's no wires. That's not an issue. There are clearly some buildings that are impinged on that you really can't prune anymore. That's conceded. There are a few trees that look unhealthy. There are a few trees that it looks like they might be causing some damage to bricks. But for the most part, most of those trees, and I would, again, I think 22 is a good estimate, a good two-thirds of those trees really could be saved. And that's what we're asking you to consider today, that taking an all or nothing approach like we did the last time really doesn't further us as a town or the communication between us, the people of the town, and those who represent us. Again, the last thing I need to do is just be seen as an adversary. I'd like to have something that's collaborative. Thank you.
Can I ask you whether you're going to take any questions? Can I ask you a question?
Yes, you may.
So my understanding is that whatever is presented today, you have 3 days to make a decision.
That's correct.
And are you willing, as the tree warden, this time to, rather than consider these 38 trees as a unit, consider these trees individually?
I will look at them again. It would be a waste of time having this hearing. I can't tell you what the outcome would be, but I would certainly take a look at the trees again.
So the 38 trees that we're talking about, you have the power to decide, even though they're all tagged, that some portion of those could stay and some portion of those really need to go.
If I change my mind, yes.
If you change your mind. And if you do not change your mind and you decide in whatever manner you make your decision that it's all or none, I just want to be clear. My read and what I've heard the process is you have 3 days to make your decision, and then you come back and either say 22 can go and...
Well, my decision would be posted in the town clerk's office. And you also, if, for example, if my decision were to go ahead and remove all the trees, you would have 10 days to appeal to the Supreme Court of Connecticut.
In writing.
I believe it is.
And 3 days is 3 business days or 3 days?
It's 3 days. So,
Monday.
That would be Monday, yes.
It would be Monday. And you would post it in the town clerk's office?
Yes. The next speaker would be the list that I got from Larry of Concerned Citizens, I think.
Thanks for holding this hearing.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. So I would say the only reason that this has progressed to the point that is that, that I'm representing in the hearing today is that I support the right tree in the right place. And as the councilman eloquently pointed out, not every tree needs to come out. Some trees do need to come out. And I think that's often a misconception that it's people who want trees versus people who don't want trees. And if this were a process of this tree and the question of its health, I think this would be a very different conversation. And none of us really want this to be adversarial. We really want this to be a dialogue. So in that vein, and I should introduce myself, I'm sorry, I'm Jerry Leo, and I'm resident of the town and the Long Green Greening Committee. So with that in mind, I spent part of this week going to the downtown businesses to ask them their opinion about this and to inform them of the process of what's going to happen. In my experience, the best way is to engage the people who live or work where trees are, where public decisions are being made. And I heard some heartbreaking stories. I talked to Mia at the boutique, who feels like she's on the brink of closing her business. She feels that she has been asking the town for years to take care of the tree in front of her property. She's been asking for planters, she loves some greenery, but she feels like it's gotten to the point where the trees are blocking her signage, and it's really hurt her business, and she was heartbroken. I talked to Richard Frank at our Frank Printers, who presented some really straightforward and logical approaches to how if you were interested in reaching out to the downtown businesses, you could get their opinion on it. It doesn't have to be a laborious process, but you could ask their opinion in a way that would be a democratic process. I talked to Therese at Serenity Spa, who said for 3 years she asked for the town to care for the tree that was in her property. And finally, when she was pregnant, she tripped on one of the tree roots. And then, only then, did the town swoop in and remove the tree in front of her property. I talked to Erin at Kelly Jeweler, who said she's really concerned with the property and how it's pulling up the bricks in front. She's been asking for that for years to be taken care of. So I would say the underlying messages are twofold. One is people are pleading for the town to be transparent with them. They would love some input on this process. They want people to talk to them. Some of them are in support of trees, some are not. Many people just want to say what happens, and that's really their request. But most of them were also really concerned cost structure of this and how the town has really shirked the responsibility to maintain the trees, and we're somewhat aghast at the idea that we would spend upwards of $500-$600 per tree to replace this, but nothing to maintain the trees, nothing to prevent some of the accidents and the heartbreak that businesses have experienced. I will say I was personally quite taken aback when I had a meeting with you and the mayor. You said that not a single person objected to the process of how you went about putting the extra trees. And I thought about that after, and I thought, gosh, how many people were here lodging their objections? And I thought, maybe nobody put it in writing. And so that was part of what I did this week. I have a list of some of the downtown businesses. I did not get to everyone. There were many that were closed when I went. There were many who I could could not talk to the owner because they weren't there. But I asked some of the businesses downtown, we're simply asking for you to come talk with them. They would love to be part of this process. And obviously, at 4 o'clock on Friday, many of them are operating their businesses, and it's a shame they recognize they would love to be here. But for the very reason that this town is in a healthy place downtown right now, they couldn't be here. They have businesses to represent. And so I have this list. I will hand it to you when I step away from the microphone, because I would like to formally submit that there are some objections to the removal and replanting process. I would say, in that regard, I remember Paul Pinder, very eloquently getting up here and objecting to the way the trees were handled when it came to the Quinnipiac Street trees in the Old Dublin. And I'm sure you would appreciate an apology knowing that in your minds there was no objection to what happened with the Quinnipiac Street trees. So two things again, the transparency and the cost. And some of the questions that I have, and you can or cannot answer these, is how many businesses do you need to hear from order to take this into account? Do you plan to remove any of the healthy trees that are downtown? How much do you expect to spend on this? I think just undercutting or going to the bottom line of what the councilman laid out. If we solely look at this from a cost perspective, I think there are lots of issues that are wrapped up in here. But there are cheaper options that are better options, and we'd love to see those explored. I was discouraged definitely that as the Green Committee, we put together some recommendations that were fairly detailed, and we actually started the first meeting with a cheaper proposal. The only hitch is that you couldn't do it that year. Nurseries need time to grow the stock, but they can replant stock at significantly cheaper costs, and it was just thrown out of hand. I would love to have a dialogue. We would like to work with you. As was stated, we don't want this to be adversarial, but there are cheaper options. Only looked at the cost. There are ways to do this better, smarter, cheaper. I would love to have on the record if you expect to do this same thing in 10 or 15 years. My understanding from talking with some folks in town is that this is the third time that this has happened with the Center Street trees, so I expect that it would happen, but I would love to hear from you that this is the plan from the town, that every 10 or 15 years neglect the maintenance of the tree and then cut it down when it's gotten too big. And I would love to know if there are any other towns in Connecticut or around the U.S. that you've heard of who've had a similar approach to this, because I'm not aware of any. I'm a big fan of best practices, learning from others, and some of the things that they've done, and we'd love to exchange ideas about some of the best practices we've seen out there. It would be a two-way dialogue. So, and thank you for your time. Really, the businesses and my understanding is the citizens would just love for this to be a transparent process. So please come to the table.
Look at everyone's thoughts and opinions and analysts and analysis. And thank you.
Phil Austin, 30 North Road, Wallingford.
Done.
The moment that I'd like to commend the tree warden on some action of the past year. I have personally objected to tree removal of about 15 trees. Actually, one of them was saved from demolition. The system works. My years of working with trees, it's occurred to me that in the process of dealing with trees, there's a political part, there's a budgetary part, there's a beautification and streetscape aspect, and then there's the down-to-earth aspect of the right place for the right tree, with enough room for the roots, enough mulch to retain the soil moisture, and the regular pruning of dead and interfering branches. As I was coming into this meeting, I noticed across the street from the parking lot, one of the trees within sight of this building. There's a cherry tree that has a branch that's broken off, and apparently nobody has noticed that, and it looks like a black eye for maintaining trees. 2 days ago, I observed a tree on a scenic road, which had been had a branch removed by a backhoe in the Public Works Department. I have a photograph of that. I'm sure that it was not at the request of the tree warden, but just a matter of fact. The branch got ripped off, put the tree in danger of insect and disease infestation. But the rest of the trees here on Center Street suffer some of the same issues. Right tree, right place. What is the purpose of the tree? I don't like to see the trees just cut down for the sake of cutting them down. But what is the purpose of those trees? Is it to provide a little bit of shade for the sidewalk? Is it to provide something of a visual improvement to downtown? Maybe trees don't matter. We certainly spent enough money on repaving all the roads and streets in town. We don't spend any money maintaining the trees that we already have. So I would like to see that we evaluate each tree on the list, see how it is most effective. And for instance, make a note that the oak trees on the hill or the oak trees that are planted along the sidewalk do produce acorns, which are like ball bearings when somebody steps on them. I'm not sure that it's happened here, but I have some direct family experience with a person stepping on an acorn and taking a tumble and breaking a hip. So that would be a good way to avoid that kind of a safety hazard. We don't plant more oak trees right over the sidewalk. There are other concerns, the continued maintenance of trees, like the poor cherry tree across the street hasn't been pruned. I don't believe any of the trees along Center Street have been pruned, except where the tall trucks brush against them and break off the branches. But I'd like to work with you to improve the survival of the existing trees and in the future plant better species. Thank you, Henry.
My name is Linda Mercier. I travel occasionally up and down the sidewalks. I'm in a wheelchair. I do have problems with the sidewalks, trees on them. I am in favor of the trees being taken down for the reason that a lot of times when I go down the sidewalk, the roots have lifted up the sidewalk themselves, and it's uneven, and sometimes I feel like I'm going to tip and fall over. Occasionally, a car will fly, or rather, a big truck will fly and hit a tree, and it scares the daylights out of me. It just knocks that tree to pieces. And they're so tall right now that trying to prune them on the top would just kill the tree anyway. I've also seen trees impeding the building all the way up and down Center Street. I've seen them overlapping roofs. I've seen them just, some of them that have insects infested in them. And then some of the branches just overlapping the sidewalk, so you have to duck. You know, I mean, I don't know how a walking person does it. I have to duck sometimes. And I just think that personally, I would rather see all the trees removed and a small ornamental bush put in that doesn't grow any more than 4 or 5 feet. And also, I think that the people that own those buildings, you know, that a lot of those trees are impeding their signage. You can't see what those doors are. I went there a couple of weeks ago with my daughter-in-law, went down there. I had to park up in the parking lot up above and go down the hill, and we were going to a restaurant down there. I couldn't even find the restaurant because I couldn't see the sign anywhere. So we ended up giving up on that and going somewhere else. But, you know, the whole thing is that the signs are all blocked. The trees are overlapping the buildings or touching the buildings. They're going to do damage to the buildings. In the fall, some of these trees are so tall that when the leaves fall, the buildings that have flat roofs, they have all these leaves on them and clog up all their drains and everything else. And it just, I would just personally like to see all the trees removed and bushes put in. You can put ornamental bushes in that flower and make just as good of a sight as a full-blown tree does. Plus, I think that the owners of the buildings should have the option of being able to prune these trees and bushes themselves. If the town isn't going to be doing it on a regular basis, I really think that store owners would like the option, if I was a store owner, I would like the option of being able to prune a tree so that it doesn't impede a sign or the front of the store and people can't see what you've got to sell. So that's my opinion, and that's where I stand.
Gino Zandri, 9 Ball Street Circle. What's the cost per tree to replace the trees?
Yeah, that's $450.
And who determines where the new trees are going to be located?
The existing root balls will be removed and the new tree put in the hole.
Is there
no change of location?
There's no change in any of the locations?
Not at this time.
All right, because on Quinnipiac Street, one of the issues that came up prior to the trees being removed were that they were growing into the street ornamental lighting down there, and that was an issue. You know, with the public hearing we had here, I mentioned at that time, if we're going to replant these trees, not put them in the locations where we're having existing problems.
Yeah, we did that on Quinnipiac Street. There was, I think this is the Solon Bank place, we had a tree that was obscuring the traffic light there. So we did move a couple to accommodate that.
But some of the other problems were the old trees were too close to the street light. And if you look at where you put the new ones back in, one right in front of the homeless shelter, and two across the street where the old firehouse used to be, you put them right back in the same locations, 4 feet away from the light. There's three right there that should have never been put back in. Then, there's one tree that was planted up by the railroad station that if you go try to find it now, you can't even find it because it's inside all these overgrown shrubs that are blocking the electrical transformer.
So here's four trees that should never have been put back in. It's almost $2,000 thrown right out the window. So I'm encouraging you to take a second look at the trees that are going to be planted and make sure that the problems that existed before are not going to be repeated again, because we're just taking money and throwing it out the window. My next question is, who's responsible, once these trees are planted like now, I'm going to be actually, who's responsible to maintain them?
Public Works.
Okay. Well, take a look, on the way, I noticed again, at the last council meeting, I complained, but nothing's been done. But there's weeds and the brand new trees, 3 feet tall.
I noticed them on my way in.
Yeah, well, then, I've noticed them all summer, and nothing's being done to maintain. There was no mulch put in at all on any of the new trees. So, if Public Works is responsible for maintaining these brand new trees that we spent almost $500 a piece on, then we better get doing something about it. I want to know if, is there going to be a pruning program? I know we're not going to prune trees all over the town of Wallingford, but where we're concentrating in the center of our town, is there a pruning program that's going to be established to maintain these trees that we're spending going forward?
Yes, there will, but it will be on an as-needed basis. It won't be just for the sake of keeping the public happy. It will be on an as-needed basis.
Right. Well, I mean, I know that there should be a program, because where I live now, we're on a program where there's arborists, and they come in and on a four-year cycle with trees, and they prune the trees every 4 years to maintain their shape. And we just started this program 2 years ago, and it really makes a huge difference in not only the how long a tree's going to last. You get twice the life out of a tree if you maintain it than you will if you just let it go wild. If you go further south, further west on Quincy Avenue, all of those pears that were planted down by the park down there, totally out of control. And this is why they have to be cut down every so many years, because nobody's maintaining these things as we're going along. So my recommendation is, whatever you're going to do on Center Street, take a second look. Make sure we're not planting these trees 4 feet to an ornamental pole. And if that's where we're located now, then don't put one back. They're saved $450. And we definitely have to start maintaining the stuff we already planted. Thank you.
Good afternoon. My name is Carol Glico, 26 Jenner Road. I don't want anyone and yourself to feel that this lack of concern is how the general public feels. I think the time of the meeting is one factor, but I've talked to a lot of people. I don't live on this side of town, I live in Yalesville, and generally the people feel like, why are you even bothering going to that meeting? What's going to be done is going to be done. And I seem to feel that they're right because of what happened in the past. I've had the opportunity to see old pictures of Wallingford. I can't believe the huge trees that were part of downtown that at that time no one maintained. The stores, every store was occupied with a business, every store. No one complained. The trees do add. You don't want a concrete jungle. It does make the town look good. But I think we need to think other than trees. I think there are areas where we can put, maybe on the corner, a nice sized shrub with maybe a bench where people can sit and just look down. I mean, looking down downtown Wallingford from Center Street, it's It's absolutely gorgeous. We are so fortunate to have this beautiful landscape. But then to have this kind of concern and people coming and being upset, we're upset about this, Henry. We're just not making a point. We're upset that people aren't listening to us and that we want to keep our town beautiful. So that's what I have to say.
Last name, Anderson.
Richard Deal, 43 Brentwood Drive. The first comment is that most everybody has spoken here today has really lifted up important issues. Maintenance, find a program for planting that's balanced. My wife grew up here in Wallingford. She's been a longtime resident. I had the experience of being one of the staff members of the Congregational Church here when the parade ground had all those nice trees planted. And I couldn't believe it. When they went in, they were, 7 feet tall. Look at them now. Beautiful. And in the fall, and in the spring, the beauty of Wallingford is unbelievable in terms of its esoteric value. My wife and I have commented constantly about how beautiful it is now than it used to be 20 years ago in terms of some of those magnificent trees that are now here. I think the maintenance issue is a serious one. That when you plant a tree, you have to love it, and you have to care for it. And I think that issue has just come up a few minutes ago about who's responsible to take care of this. The trimming, the shape of the tree. Now, we have two concerns about planting, too. If a tree is causing the pavement to cause a hazard, then that tree shouldn't be in there. You can't keep ripping up the sidewalk, but you can take a tree out. So sometimes it's necessary to plan so that if a tree is interfering on passages, that needs to be taken care of. That's one issue. The other issue that I have is that there has to be a kind of planting. I think somebody just mentioned that there are three trees at the corner next to the old firehouse that probably would have saved you a lot of money if they hadn't been planted there. And the question was why those three were so close together. I think you're probably the one responsible as an architect, if that's correct, of making sure things are spaced out correctly. And I think that our concern is, number one, keep up the work of beautifying this beautiful town, Wallingford. I've been here long enough to know, just in my short 30 years, that there's been a terrific change in terms of the way this place looks than what it looked 30 years ago. It's much more beautiful. And I commend anybody who has spoken today because I heard some very wonderful ideas that are given to you as to how to do it. And that's always the question, how do you do it? It's not so much in what, it's more than how. And if a tree is imposing upon the electrical system, then it has to be trimmed or taken out. And if it interferes with somebody's passage and the pavement is pushed up by the tree, then it has to be taken care of. But that's our comment. We want to keep the esoteric value of Wallingford looking the way it has looked and how it can look. And that's our comment.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. that was up the street this way. My daughter has a few things she likes.
Just have a, I don't know if this is a good place, but I'm going to make a suggestion anywhere. Anyway, I know that from personal experience that her plate is pretty full most of the time. I was just wondering about the possibility of creating a position of part-time tree warden in town hall for being full-time, but someone who could devote all their attention to the care and pruning of trees and planting and removing. That has to be discussed with the mayor or the city council, but
thank you very much. Thank you, Emma.
Hello, Henry. Thanks for having us in the meeting. I'd just like to read into the record a letter that I wrote as the chair of WCI to Mayor Dickinson. Wallingford Center Incorporated Board directed me to reinforce and support the request from our greening committee to extend the conversation about tree replacement on Center Street. We oppose replacement of all adjacent trees and continue to favor the approach where no more than one out of three trees is replaced at one time, with a minimum of 5 years before additional tree removal. This approach, combined with increased pruning and maintenance, will serve our downtown best. Thank you for the opportunity to voice our concerns as dated September 4th. Thank you.
I just need your name.
Julie Rogers, 355 North Main Street. I'm sorry I'm late. I don't know if I missed the answer to this, but I did want to comment, just also say that the fact that you're going through with cutting down the trees is disappointing. And I know there was the Wallingford Greening Committee that was assembled to give you recommendations. Did you take into consideration any of the recommendations that they gave? Did they change your plan at all?
No, we did take their ideas into consideration. We decided to go with the town.
And did the town consult with other, I'm sure there are other towns that have similar situations with trees in downtown areas like this. Does the town consult with any of them for any, to see what they do?
No, we did not.
And how about, I think I read that, as someone mentioned earlier, initially this came about because business owners were saying the trees were blocking the signage. I don't know how many business owners there were, but of the multiple businesses on Center Street, were they all consulted, or was it, were they given a chance to, you know, say, whoa, no, or did you ask all of them?
We didn't consult with any of the business owners. This is part of it was a plan that was laid out. In fact, there's a letter went to the town council in June of last year that the town planned to replace all of the trees that are, they're around 16 years old, Center Street, Simpson Court, North and South Main Street, that were all part of the improvements done like 16, 17 years ago. This is phase two of an ongoing plan.
So it doesn't have to do with the signs on the business signs?
The trees are too big. Okay. And that's the reason they're being cut down. The trees are simply too big.
And then just lastly, I'd like to say that, as the nice woman mentioned earlier, please, you know, there's not a ton of people here, but as a parent of young children, after school time, it's tough to get here this time, but just for the record, you know, I think it's a bad idea. Other people have said that pruning and trimming, and there are different ways to go about it, and I know others agree, but couldn't be here, so thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Thanks for having our Warren Ash report. Henry, was there a maintenance program over the last 10 years? There was one,
no.
And someone mentioned that they thought that might be an important part going forward. I believe you said maintenance will be conducted on an as-needed basis.
That's correct.
But can you elaborate on?
Well, if a tree doesn't need to be pruned or any work done on it, then we wouldn't do anything to the tree, but other trees need to be pruned, the action would be taken.
But there hasn't been a program over the last 10 years, so when you say it on an as-needed basis, is that basically saying there isn't any program going forward in the next 10 years?
No, we don't have a program, no.
And you don't see a need for that?
Yes, I can take a serious look at that, yeah. I'd have to see what the cost would be for something like that. Everything has a cost.
And that hasn't been done yet?
I haven't considered that or investigated that yet.
But you're going to investigate
that? I am going to do that.
Do you see an advantage to doing that?
Yes. Yes, I can.
And what would that be in your estimation? What's the advantage of having some type of a program to maintain?
Well, I think you could maintain the shape of the tree better. You can't reduce the height of the tree. The trees are going to grow. And these trees, the new trees are 16 years old. It's going to be time to remove them again. You cannot reduce the size of the tree.
But you do agree there would be some benefit.
Let me see how that problems growing into limit them up to the proper height and so forth.
Perfect.
Anyone else? Thank you all for attending, and you will have my answer probably Monday afternoon, Tuesday morning. Thanks for coming.